This patient had an inhomogeneous nodule in her right thyroid. Our first impression would be that this is a very suspicious nodule because it has great number of echogenic granules within. This pattern highly resembles, at first glance, the starry sky phenomenon of a papillary cancer. However, if we stop this video almost at any time, we can see also lines, not only granules. I stop again, line, granule, granule, granule. In this section, granules prevail over line. In this section, line, 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 granule, granule. So the essence of this pattern that echogenic granules and lines occur simultaneously. Okay, this is a quite rare example. So although I'm convinced that these figures correspond very likely to fibrotic changes, because most of these lines do not show a ventral cystic area. So these are not these are located not dorsal to cystic areas, but these occur in a solid part. But I can imagine that there are some cystic fluid within this nodule, and these are interpreted, these should be interpreted as backflow figures. The difference is nothing between proliferation of connective tissue and backflow figures. The differentiation is between microcalcification and not microcalcification. So it is a rare example, and despite that I do not think that these are microcalcifications, it is clear that this nodule should be evaluated cytologically and should be evaluated more carefully. I stopped again. Here, lines, lines, lines. In this section, lines clearly prevail over granules. So our first impression was in this nodule that starry sky phenomenon should be considered. On thorough analysis, it became evident that these should not be interpreted as microcalcifications. It would be not a failure if we raise the possibility that these figures can be microcalcification, but it would be clearly a failure if we clearly stated that these figures are microcalcifications. So this example added something to our differential diagnostic problems. Not a frequent finding intranodular fibrotic changes, but we can meet patients with such a pattern, and in such cases the reanalysis of the video is the clue to avoid unfounded statement on our medical report. The nodule has perinodular vascularity. Here continuously, here some spots according to the periphery, and some intranodular vascularity can be also found, but this is not a suspicious pattern. On ultrasound aspiration, I try to find the tip of the needle. Yes, here we can see. I show it once more. Here will appear the tip of the needle now. So this was our fourth case.